Claramente.
I created this project, I visualized this project with my experience earlier. Earlier I developed Hyderabad in a big way. I gave a vision 2020. To achieve that, I developed Hyderabad. Everything what I planned, it has been executed very well. And today, Hyderabad is rated one of the most livable city in the country with trunk infrastructure and better living standards. And also all facilities for that matter, either outer ring road or airport or Cyberabad city or human resources, everything, metro, everything. It contributes now 65 to 70% of revenue requirement for Telangana. That is how it has been developed. With that experience, I planned Amaravati. It is a self-financing project. If you complete this project, again, Andhra Pradesh will get maximum revenue, employment, and also this is the center of activity, either political activity or administration or judiciary, everything. We want to go hub and spoke model. First, Amaravati is the capital, then regional centers, Visakhapatnam, Tirupati, and Nellore, even other cities, Anantapur, Karnool, all cities we want to develop. Meanwhile, this man has destroyed the concept of Amaravati and also is killing Amaravati. And finally, he wanted to destroy Andhra Pradesh. No development in Andhra Pradesh as of now. He is talking all tall promises of giving subsidy. Where is money? There is no money. Where he is going to give? He cannot give anything. There is a financial doldrum in Andhra Pradesh.
Sir, YSRCB has been alleging that much corruption took place in the name of Amaravati capital construction. What do you say?
He is the most corrupt politician in the country itself. All politicians put together how much corruption they have done. That is the amount he acquired through corrupt means. He is talking about corruption. Can he prove? 6 months are over. He has any guts or any reason, can he establish now? How much time he need? Where is corruption here? Why he is talking all rubbish? He want to destroy Amaravati. He want to destroy Andhra Pradesh development. So he is blaming only corruption. He is unable to prove corruption. Then what is the right he is having to talk about corruption? I'm challenging him.
Sir, Minister Bosa commented whether you are going to see graveyard. What do you think? What is made the such harsh comment?
If you see this area, is it graveyard? They are functioning in graveyard. Where is secretary? Where is that ministry is working? Where is assembly? Where is high court? They are all sitting in graveyards. Is it right? Even high court is functioning in a graveyard. This the type of arrogancy, very bad. They are all only vulgar language they are using, plenty language they are using. They don't know if they open their mouth, it is very horrible to hear from them. These very bad trends they are establishing. I totally condemn them. It is very, even 5 crore people of Andhra Pradesh will have a feeling and all their sentiments are hurt very badly because of this type of comments.
Sir, we saw that some farmers are agitating and showing black placards.
They are all hired people of ISRCP. Any fellow, any political party or a chief minister can do this type of activity. I am ex-chief minister of Andhra Pradesh and also opposition leader and also 25 years I am the party president. I am visiting this area. Can you do that? Any persons will come on roads and demonstrate like that, except hired people. Even I am appealing them. It is your future, your children's future. This city will develop. You will have an advantage. Why you are becoming instruments or YSR Congress is using you to destroy your future. Don't fall in that trap. That is what I am appealing them. This is very bad for them. If today they may give some money for doing this type of activities, But ultimately, you are going to lose heavily. Your children will lose, you will lose livelihood, you will lose your future. That is what I want to tell them. Sir, and also, you will be instrumental for destroying the future of Andhra Pradesh. 5 crore people.
Sir, government is claiming that your plan of Amravati construction is a big financial burden.
It is a self-financing project. If you spend money, you will get revenue. Again, if you spend money, you will get revenue. This is how industries, this is how infrastructure, this is how cities have built over a period of time. If I thought Hyderabad like that, I didn't develop Hyderabad, where is revenue today? What I'm saying, I considered airport. How I considered airport? Airport is with a passion. First of its kind in India, Hyderabad Airport in Greenfield. Today, Hyderabad Airport is contributing 60 to 70% of GSDP of Telangana. That is where development will lies. These people are saying money. Who asked you money? There is a self-finance. Farmers give money, the land. Through land monetization, everything is possible. Even there is surplus money for other developmental activities, other welfare programs. It is a matter of time. What is economy? Somebody has to produce product, somebody has to consume, either industry or agriculture or service.
Sir, last question. In this kind of situation, is any possibility to join hand with the central ruling BJP for solving this problem in interest of the state?
No, as a matter of fact, it is the stakeholders are 5 crore people of Andhra Pradesh directly and indirectly the people of India. Hyderabad we developed, so many people got employment and revenue for the state, and also government of India is getting some money through taxes, income tax, central excise, all these things, service tax, all these things. So I will apprise, first of all I want to sensitize people, this is a wealth creation. This is revenue generation, this is employment generation. Then ultimately I want to sensitize the nation. Finally, I want to brief all leaders, including Honorable Prime Minister, what is happening, how to rescue or how to continue this type of projects. Nobody is having right to destroy the future of future generations. That is my idea.